Action News Now Storm Tracker Weather. Coverage you can count on.
Welcome back. It is finally Friday. Court Clopping joins us now. And our weekend is really looking, I mean, not crazy, stormy, but
yeah, it could be a lot worse. In fact, as we head into next week, conditions are going to get much stronger as far as rain and snow is concerned. North of our neck of the woods is where we're going to be seeing the brunt of the storm system moving through this weekend. And we do have a winter weather advisory in effect right now for the western portion of Siskiyou County and for portions of Modoc County. Now, we could be seeing 6 to 12 inches of snowfall through 10 p.m. Sunday night in those areas, down to 3,500 feet. We're also looking at potential for gusts out of the south, 45 to 50 miles an hour in those areas. So that's where we're going to see seeing some of the worst of what's on the way. And then as we move into next week, we're looking at potential for very heavy snowfall on the way. Monday's system could dump a foot of snow as it is itself. So heading into next week, conditions are getting much stronger. As far as what we're seeing out there tonight, snow and rain showers are returning. This looks very similar to the system that we had Tuesday night into early Wednesday, which means it's primarily going to impact mountain areas with very limited showers in the valley. Snow levels hovering around 35 to 4,000 feet, 3,500 to 4,000 feet, and then more showers moving in as we head through next week. So through the weekend, lighter, more modest showers, and then next week, much more substantial. Satellite and radar, we're tracking showers moving through the northern mountains right now. Through the evening, we're going to start to see more of those spreading across the majority of the northern zones of our region. So what's going on here is we have this low pressure area pushing into the Pacific Northwest. The main event is really to our north. So Washington and Oregon seeing a much heavier amount of rain and snowfall than what we're going to be seeing here specifically. But as you take a look at what we're going to see through tonight, by around 7 to 8 p.m., showers moving through the north end of the valley. So Redding looking likely to see some wet weather. South of Redding, not so much for the valley. And then we do see that moving into the Sierra and Cascades later on this evening. Snowfall becoming a bit heavier, 10 p.m. to midnight, and then continuing overnight, becoming a bit more scattered early on tomorrow. And then by tomorrow afternoon, we're expected to stay mostly dry. The majority of the showers on Sunday are specifically expected to stay mainly in the northern mountains, some making it into the Sierra, and a chance for showers again in Redding. So if you're in the valley, most of us are expected to stay dry. Redding definitely looks like the exception there. Temperatures tomorrow are going to end up in the mid-30s to low 40s in the northern mountains. Rain and snow mix overnight into the early morning hours tomorrow. We'll see showers overnight into the early morning for the Sierra and Cascades. Temperatures in the 30s to 40s tomorrow afternoon. Foothill areas are going to see temperatures in the 40s for the most part tomorrow afternoon after dropping into the 30s to low 40s overnight. Showers possible in the morning but dry in the afternoon. Low 40s for the northern valley tonight. We'll see a chance for showers on the way. Tomorrow, mid-50s on the way for your afternoon. It will be dry for the afternoon, and Redding does look like the most likely area to see showers in the valley. A chance for showers not looking too likely in the mid-valley with low 40s tonight, ending up in those low to mid-50s for tomorrow afternoon and dry for the afternoon hours tomorrow. Through your weekend, most of the showers, again, staying in the North Valley and higher elevations. We'll see low to mid-50s Saturday, low 50s Sunday, and then much more likely see widespread rain and snow returning from that system Monday into Tuesday, and then a colder and more potent system likely Wednesday and through the end of next week. So through this weekend, it's a little bit lighter. Heading into next week, it becomes much more substantial and it gets a lot colder.
Okay, cross that bridge when we come to it.
That's right.
Thanks, Court. Well, coming up.